want to sell your car? I show you how to take amazing photos of your ride. Taking photos of your ride is not that difficult. I show you in 5 easy steps how to get the most out of your vehicle. And the first thing you of course need to do is clean it up. But before we go, let's open the roof. It's a convertible. With cars, it's just like with portrait photography. You don't go to a portrait photographer all messed up. Don't wash your hair, don't dress up properly, don't maybe use makeup. You want to get the best out of you that the photographer can capture the best of you. And with a car, it's the same. Nobody buys a dirty, shitty car. Boom! Almost looks like new. And now comes number 2, the proper location. A proper location is just as important as the washing, the makeup part of the car. The better you are prepared, the better you can photograph it. What I look for now for a location is something that fits to the car. This is my wife's car. So I have my 4x4 big off-road truck, but this is my wife's car. So I will photograph it in a way that attracts people that like that car, that convertible. So maybe something like palms, blue sky, not a disturbing background, something clean and big enough that I can later move around with my camera, get further away, and just have the car as a nice red thing in the image and nothing that is disturbing in the background or might attract the view of the proper buyer of your car. This spot is not too bad. We have a nice background and it's a very open area, an old parking lot. And what I will do now to give the whole scenery some extra kick is I will turn my front wheels just a bit to the left that we can see the whole rim. Not on the wrong side, not like this, that we just see the tire or something, but in this direction, nice rims. Then we can take the photos. All right, we found a great location. We cleaned the car and just with the eye, it looks amazing here at this spot. You can now take photos just with your smartphone. So when I just take the smartphone now and take the image something like this, it does look good already, but it can even look better with a lot more quality when you use a real camera. In my case now, I use a 50 millimeter lens and it's important to use a longer lens. When you are very wide angled, you won't get that nice blurry background. So I'm on 50 millimeters, 1.4 maximum open aperture. You can use a 1.8 as well. And it does not have to be expensive. There is the Yongnuo lens out. It costs something like 45 euro. I made a whole video about that. Check that out. And I could use this lens totally now as well. And when I now just take the same photo with this lens here, with the open aperture lens and the real camera, not with a shitty smartphone, same perspective, same everything. And look how different the image quality looks. I focus somewhere on the front of the car, somewhere on the front rim, which we nicely slide it to the side, and that looks amazing. Compare both of the images and tell me which image you like more. Number 4, it's all about perspective. And what I would always recommend is go very low with your perspective. Just from the head, just the usual head perspective shot is very boring. A car looks much more amazing when you photograph it down from the bottom. So something like this, very flat on the ground, then just pull the focus or use the autofocus on the car and then just take the shot. As well from this side maybe, some different background. All right, the front shot and the back shot is the most important shot. I want to see how the car looks, how does it feel when I look on the car or at the car when I want to buy the car. I want to see the front, the face and the back, the ass of the car. And then what I would do next is I would go a lot higher and take a shot from the top. Something like this, and it's great to have a screen that you can flip just like this. And then I will do the whole shot from the top, and that usually gives you an even more interesting perspective. When you do the back shot of the car, it's important that you turn the car around and as well look for the background. And that's a good example. That's why I said look for the background for the whole scenery, because now when I take a photo of this, there's this house in the background, the mountain in the background, it's not that far away, and we have that ugly trash wagon there, which, yeah, looks just like trash, so don't put it in your image. So I turn the car around now and take the ass shot. You've taken some nice images of the front and of the back, and now it's time for the details. And usually I take a cockpit shot first, so I just photograph the cockpit through the seats, sometimes through the window, through an open window, just through the back of this convertible. And what I then would photograph is damage. So wherever is some beauty damage or just some real damage, I would photograph it and upload it as well, because it's honest. And the beauty shot from the front, the beauty shot from the back is just like the bait. You want the bait for the person who wants to buy the car, who's interested in buying maybe a convertible, a red convertible for summer, for whatever. And then he should also see reality, because the car is beautiful and it drives good, but it has as well some damage already. And it's just honest to photograph that, to show that as well. So take a nice detailed shot with an open aperture of the cockpit, and then the last shots maybe of some damage, and write it in the text as well. And then you will get very honest, interesting persons. Because when you don't do it, don't document the damage, it might be that a lot of people are interested in your car, want to see the car, but then they come and then they see, oh, there's damage, why didn't you tell us that there is damage? So it's always better to say it first. Those were 5 tips for you that you can take better photos to sell your car, and I wish you good luck with selling your car. Write me if it worked out with the tips I gave you, and show the video to a friend who maybe wants to sell his or her car. And I can honestly say, with better photos you can get more money for your vehicle, even if it's the same vehicle, because you can set the price maybe higher and find prospects, then you can negotiate and then get a nice price for better quality images. So better quality images are always a good thing. Quick commercial, if you want to learn more about photography, check out learnfromben.com. This is my website, and there we got video courses about photography, about image editing, that you can download on your computer, watch as often as you want, and then just take better photos. learnfromben.com. See you on the next video. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and I see you there. Bye bye.